The Echuya Forest Encroachment Concern was raised during the 6th Biodiversity Conservation Forum Conference for Echuya Landscape, which was organized by Nature Uganda at Cephas Inn Hotel in Kabale Municipality. The forum was established in 2008 under the People Partner with Nature program of Nature Uganda, funded by Bird Life Partner in Denmark, with the objective of sharing lessons learned, best practices and achievements, challenges and opportunities for conservation in the landscape of Kashohia, Kitomi and Echuya. Herbert Turiahabwa, a forest supervisor attached to the National Forestry Authority in Rubanda District, says that since he joined Echuya Forest in 2016, they've given out over 5,000 bamboo seedlings to the locals to discourage them from encroaching on the forest for the trees. He also alleges people from neighboring Rwanda steal humus-filled soils from the forest.
You can see patrols around that area. That area at the border between Rwanda and the Kashasha. We're intensifying the patrol, regular patrols, and on foot. And we're working with local leaders to curtail this vice.
Turiahabwa attributes the challenge to limited monitoring and enforcement by the authorities, since they have a small team of workers who cannot manage the entire forest reserve.
To work with the detached at Kanaba, at least to control this illegal activity. And you know the border problem here. If you go there and you get them here, they just run to their area and you can't cross. If you go there, then I think you bring the last, I think. So if you are there, there is still a problem, but there is some hope that the border will be opened and we shall have a cross border.
There are ongoing efforts to empower local communities in conservation approaches to protect the forest.
How can the communities benefit? How can we improve livelihoods of the people where they are? Because when you conserve the forest, you don't get food. When you conserve the forest, you don't get money directly. You get ecosystem services, but you don't get food directly. This forest is the main catchment, water catchment area for Kawale, for Rwanda, and for Kisoro district. This is where we all depend in terms of water provision. So it is important for them. But when you're talking to people, they want something that they can look at tomorrow. If they live here, can they have food on the table when they reach home?
Nature Uganda gave us seed money, 6 million shillings. Started as a circle. Now, people have gained much in boosting their agricultural products.
Uganda should come to support my programs as a district, not to bring its own projects. So yesterday we rolled out a good plan, forest management plan. It would be embarrassing when Mudanga is not in charge of that plan and instead he's attending a workshop as if he's a watcher or he's coming to pick it out.
Echuya is a montane rainforest in southwestern Uganda, adjoining the border with Rwanda. It lies in the Albertine Rift section of the Eastern Afro-Montane Hotspot, the most endemic-rich region in Africa. Covering 34 square kilometers, the forest includes a high-altitude swamp called Muchuya, which is home to an important population of 30 to 50 pairs of the endangered Groya swamp warbler, and the entire reserve is considered a priority amongst BirdLife International's 30 Ugandan important bird areas. This report was compiled by Job Namanya for the news in Kigezi.